Just landed in NCL. Luckily, Greg, the saviour, picked me up from the airport in the German whip. He was there waiting for me at arrivals. Decent little flight, 35 minutes, no delays for once. So well done, EasyJet. Obviously you need to know the time because I love updating people with the time on vlogs. 10:28 exactly. Now, apparently, I've got to go straight to Chrissy's house to edit a video for him because he's got a, psychology or something. So psychology video that he needs edited because he has to hand it in tomorrow morning. So I'm gonna have to go and do that. Late night grind. And then hopefully, me and Greg, don't know where Greg's gone, we'll do some decent gym vlogs starting from tomorrow. Shout out to Greg, give me a lift from the airport. No worries. Catch you tomorrow. Hello. Managed to scare my grandma successfully. Right, so as you just saw, haven't seen my grandma for 3 weeks, and she was very excited to see me. Time is 10 o'clock, it is Tuesday. Arrived in Newcastle last night. Now I'm on my way to the gym with Greg. Greg's in a different car because he's going to uni straight from the gym. And this is gonna be my first ever gym-based YouTube video. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take you through the routine that I've been doing for the last 2 weeks, which is a push-pull legs routine. Taking you through this workout today for the first time, and I'm also gonna be taking Greg through it for the first time. So let's see how it goes. Obviously, I became accustomed to it yet because I've only been doing it 2 weeks and it is quite a hard workout. Oh my God, this roundabout's flooded. We're no longer in the German whip. We are in the Agila. Pre-workout is just a black coffee. Don't ask why it's in a Nutri Ninja shaker, but it just is. And you might have noticed there's also a straw in there. That's because whenever I drink black coffee, I usually forget to have a straw. And if you forget to have a straw, for every black coffee you drink, your teeth are gonna get blacker, which is really not what you want, especially if you wanna have pearly whites. So I'm gonna drink this coffee now because we're almost at the gym, and then I'll see you inside the gym. So basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to talk you through the workout that I've been doing over the last couple of weeks. So starting with day one, which is today, which is push routine A. So obviously with this workout, you do push twice a week, pull twice a week, and legs twice a week. Now in each of the workouts, you start with a compound lift, a heavy compound lift. And throughout the workouts, you do heavy, a medium lift, and a light lift. Throughout the workout, but I will talk to you more about what the routine entails in another video. Today I'm just going to talk to you. You have around 80% of your one rep max on the bar. So I had 40 kilograms each side and the bar, which is 20, so 100 kilograms. Now obviously it's important to understand that I have sped up the video slightly, just so we can get through everything without you having to sit there and watch me do 5 sets of bench press, which obviously could be pretty boring. So as you can see, I completed the 5 sets of heavy, doing 3 reps for each set. I've then dropped the weight down to 30 kilograms either side, which is obviously 60 kilograms. The bar's 20, so that's 80. And I'm just going for as many reps as I can possibly get with good form. Once the form starts to fail, that's when you just re-rack the bar and that is your set complete. So I managed to get around 15 reps for the final set of bench press. Now for the second exercise, which is behind the neck shoulder press, you have to do 3 sets, and in the 3 sets, try and do 25 reps. So the way I like to split it is by doing the first set 10 reps, second set 8 reps, and the third set 7 reps. I've only got 12.5 kilograms on either side here, and obviously we're using the Smith machine for this as it kind of stabilizes the barbell for you. So I did manage to do 1 set of 10, 1 set of 8, and 1 set of 7. Now for the behind the neck shoulder press and this next exercise, which is tricep dips, it's important that you only have 60 seconds rest between each set. So like I just said, the third exercise is tricep dips. You want to do 3 sets of 10 reps for this exercise. Now my form and stuff may not be that good during this exercise because I've only just been able to start doing these again because I had a few problems with my front delts. However, since starting this 2 weeks ago, today is the first day that I actually managed to get 3 sets of 10 reps. So for the fourth exercise, we are doing cable crossovers. As you can see, we've got the cables coming from quite high up and they're also quite wide, allowing us to get a good stretch. We're not doing too heavy at all here. In fact, I think we're doing about 12.5 kilograms on either cable. Now in the routine, it says to do 5 sets of 10 reps. So we did exactly that. It's very important that on your way down, you really do squeeze your chest as you're coming in. This means that you are contracting the muscle and allowing the muscle group to work just that little bit harder. Finally, feel free to adjust your leg position. So have your left leg forward, right leg forward, both your legs together, just changing it around and see what you like best. The fourth exercise is just a tricep pull down using the tricep rope. We aim to do around 5 sets of 10 reps during the tricep exercise, and again, we're not going too heavy at all. We're using about 35 kilograms, which isn't too much, and just focusing on form. One thing to be aware of when you're doing a tricep pull down is just to not lean too far into the movement, as then you start to take focus away from the triceps and using other muscle groups. But that's pretty much it for triceps, and the next exercise is a lateral raise. So as I just said, we are doing single arm lateral raises. One thing to be aware of when doing this exercise is not to lift too heavy and use your whole body swinging into it. I'm only using a 5 kilogram dumbbell here, and the routine suggests doing 5 sets of 10 reps. So that's 10 reps on each arm. A set would be 20 reps in total, 10 on your left, 10 on your right. Obviously, feel free to go heavier if you're comfortable with that. But like I said, I had a few problems with my delts not too long ago, so I do like to just be extra careful. Now I did do all 10 reps of 5 sets on each arm, but as you're about to see, the camera starts to fall off the weight and then it tells me the battery is dead. So that concludes that workout.